Your car battery has a positive side and a negative side. It's important to not get those two mixed up, or you could damage your expensive electrical system. But what is the difference between these two posts when it comes to electricity? Because this is a DC system, DC meaning direct current, electricity only travels in one direction. What direction that happens to be will differ on paper depending on if you are using conventional flow or electron flow. Your natural instinct with these labels may be to assume that the positive is where a surplus of something is, and the negative is where that surplus wants to go. This is conventional flow, the way we thought about electricity in the early days of understanding it. However, electrical theory has progressed, and our understanding of atomic structure leads to a different theory of flow. That sentence sounded like what a director would tell a scientist to say in the background of a shot. Anyway, you remember how an atom is made up of protons, neutrons, and electrons? Protons having a positive charge, neutrons being neutral, and electrons being not just negatively charged, but also not part of the nucleus? Electrons have a negative charge, so wherever there are a lot of them, there will be a negative charge. If there's a surplus of electrons in one location and a deficit of them elsewhere, if they are given a conductive path to get there, the electrons are going to flow from the negative area to the positive area. These are clearly two opposed schools of thought. But is one more right than the other? In a way, they both exist because of the way they were initially discovered and labeled. If we knew what we know about electrons right away, we would have said that positive things orbit atoms and go from the positive side of the battery to the negative side. But that didn't happen. We can't change the labels around on batteries because everything from before the change would be mislabeled, and we can't change scientific terms because they are pretty foundational at this point. So, when dealing with the flow of electricity, just be aware of which type of theory of flow you're working with. Lots of beginner electrical lessons will use the conventional theory because it's less visually confusing for beginners, but those working with electronics in a scientific way may need to refer to the way electrons are actually flowing, so both conventional theory and electron flow theory are here to stay. Remember, conventional flow uses the conventional thinking of stuff goes from where there's too much to too little so it evens out, while electron flow theory is the more scientifically accurate one, where electrons, with their negative charges, start from where the battery is labeled negative and head to the positive side. Hopefully, this didn't make things more confusing, but to be fair, it's a pretty confusing thing to have to deal with. I mean, look at this diode symbol. Doesn't this look like it's pointing somewhere? Obviously, if the intent of this symbol is to imply that, which given that a diode allows electricity to flow one way and not the other way, then that means it would have to pick a side, either conventional or electron flow. It's pointing towards the negative side. It's pointing in the direction of conventional flow, so electron flow is counterintuitive here. As you learn more about electronics, you may gravitate towards one theory or the other because of what you find easier to remember. Like with that diode symbol, if you work with those a lot and think about the arrow shape, you may feel inclined to remember conventional theory. No matter what you choose, the important thing is to be aware of both theories existing, and the symbols, documents, or teaching materials may refer to one that you don't prefer. That's okay. It's not great, but it's okay. You don't need to tell someone teaching in conventional theory that electrons actually flow from negative to positive. It is, however, important to note in teaching materials which theory is being discussed. If you have any positive or negative feedback, there is a comment section to direct your current feelings towards. That's all for now. Thanks for watching Car Simplified.